Hi, Alex here from redeveloper.com and welcome back to ASD, App Store Domination. And today we are going to talk about UI collection views and how to set up a basic UI collection view. So without further ado, let's get to work. Okay, I'm sure you have already seen collection views, and UI collection views are the ones that you can see everywhere, basically everywhere, in the Instagram app, in the Twitter app, in the Facebook app, where feeds are provided. UI collection view is the perfect answer for that. So today we are going to talk about how you can create a simple UI collection view. So let's open up Xcode here and let's create, let me just drag this down and let's create a new project. Okay, and it will be a single view application. Let's click on next and I will name this. Let's click on next. And I will drop it onto the desktop. Yay, it is live. Okay, back to work. I want to create a new UI collection view with a double L, and I have misspelled that, I just noticed it, but okay, the main idea is the same. So let's create a new file and let's create a CocoaTouch class, because that will add the most basic, well, the necessary things that a UI collection view needs. And I will name this, let's say, Home Collection View Controller. Let's click on next and create. Okay, here we are in our Home Collection View Controller. And as you can see, there are a couple of things that are already set up. Now, the main idea is that you have some sections. And for this tutorial, we will use only one section. So I will just add return here one. So there will be only one section. And inside those sections, we have our items. And here we can give the number of items in that section. And because we have only one section, we add in here one. If you're interested in more advanced UI collection view controllers, go ahead and take a look at my LBTA components tutorial on YouTube. It is a whole playlist, so go ahead and check that out for more details. Okay, now, once we do have these numbers and at one, let's say 15, or maybe just 5 for now, then we can configure our cell. And this is where we dequeue our reusable cell with our reuse identifier. And as I have, I didn't tell you, but you most probably know that we are not going to use storyboards at all. We are going to do this all in code. So that is why this is the reuse identifier is our cell. Okay. And one last thing. We need to register it inside our view did load. So we registered our UI collection view cell for this reuse identifier, and we are getting back a default UI collection view cell. So that is, of course, we may add a new cell here, but that is out of scope of this tutorial. So we will not dive in deep. Go ahead and take a look at the LBTA components tutorial. But stick around, because now you will understand what UI collection view is all about. Okay, now that we do have this, and I will just delete these UI collection view delegates, because we are not going to talk about them, and this navigation too. Let's call upon this UI collection view controller, because we are not presenting it. So let's go. And first of all, let's delete this ugly storyboard. Let's delete it. The first thing that I always do, I delete the main.storyboard back to our project and delete the main interface there and just step away from it, and we are done. Let's go back to app delegate, and here let us create our window as a UI window. And let's make our window make key and visible. Okay, now our home collection view controller needs a UI collection flow, collection view flow layout. So first of all, let us just create that layout. It will be a simple basic UI collection view flow layout. Okay, now let us instantiate our collection view. So let collection view controller CVC, and it will be a UI collection view controller, and let us just add here our collection view layout, and that is our layout that we have just created. And finally, we add this CVC controller to our Windows root view controller. So that's that. Pretty simple. And just to test this out, let's add a background color. So here you might want to call upon view, but this collection view controller has something called collection view, and that has this background color property on it. So we will call this red. Okay. And I see that there are some indentation problems because I already set up indentations to be two spaces. So I'll just simply collect and cut all of this out and paste it again, and the indentation is already set to two spaces. Pretty good stuff. And what else do I want to do? Well, I want to launch it finally. After all of this talk and work, let's launch it. Okay, let's see. Let me just make this a little smaller. Okay. And now let's wait for our iPhone 10 simulator to launch. And here we go. We should have a red background. It seems that we don't have it. And what seems to be the problem? Yes, of course. And you might have yelled at me. Okay, it is not a UI collection view controller. It is our home collection view controller. Alex, come on. So let's hit Command R again, and we now should see our red background. Congratulations. If you are if you have made it till here, then you are most probably smarter than me, because I have added the default UI collection view controller. I don't know what I was doing there. Okay, so now, what else do we want to do? Well, we want to add some cells in there. And as you can see, we already kind of told the UI collection view controller that we want 5 cells. And even if we add here our cells background color to be, let's say, even this way, we are not going to see those 5 cells. And that is because we haven't, well, we do have that, oh, good stuff, but we need to create our layout. And for that, we are going to import here, let's see, let's conform to our UI collection view flow layout delegate. And I believe it's not flow, it is layout delegate flow layout. It is a pretty mouthful, but that's it, what it is. So now what we want to do here is maybe let's add our, let's say, collect, let me just make this easier for you to read. Okay, here we have our collection view, and just type in item size, size for item at. So this is a collection view size for item at, and we are going to return a CG size, and we will choose this one with a CG float, and we want, let's say, the whole width of our view. So, and the height should be the same. Okay, let's build and run again and see what has changed. And maybe in the meantime, I will make this background to be white because the default background of a collection view is set to black. So let's just scroll here, and as you can see here, we have our five cells. Pretty good stuff, but I still want to eliminate these lines here, and for that, let me just go back and, well, let's have here half, and the height should be the same, and let's see how that looks. Okay, not as good as one might expect, and that is because first we need to set the line height. Well, these, let me just show you in code because it's much easier. So collection view, and minimum line spacing for section L, and let's return here one, and the other one is collection view, and that is, I believe it is inter item. Yeah, that's it. Minimum inter item spacing for section. Pretty mouthful, but that's what it is. So I will choose this one, and now that I want to have two cells and I want to grab minus one and then divide it by two, so that should be the width of our cell, and the same goes to our height here. Okay, let's build and run again and see the difference. Okay, there we go, two cells, pretty good. Now if we want three cells, then of course we want to grab two pixels out of our width. Okay, and let's add, let's say 15 or maybe 17, and let's build and run again. And that is how you can create that Instagramish effect. Okay, now one last thing I want to add here, and I will wrap all of this up, is when you tap on all of these cells. So for that, it's pretty simple. Collection view and did select. Yes, that it is did select item add. And for now, I will just print out. Maybe grab and add here our index paths row. And of course, our current index path section will always be zero because we have only one section available in this UI collection view controller. Okay, let's tap the first one. Here we go, zero and zero. Tap select. The next one, next one, next one, next one, next one. Pretty easy and straightforward. So there you go. Now you know how you can easily create a UI collection view controller. Hope you enjoyed this lesson. And as usual, I will see you tomorrow in the next one. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below, and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.